Good evening. You're watching Epicenter. At the stroke of the midnight hour on 26th of January, India's maximum city, Mumbai, will officially go into 24/7 mode. The city that never sleeps will now, under law, never sleep. Here is what has happened today. Maharashtra's 29-year-old tourism minister, Aditya Thackeray, has pushed through a proposal as old as himself that will allow malls, restaurants, multiplexes and shopping plazas to operate through the night. He has cited London's night economy that is valued at some $5 billion currently to say that the move will generate employment and bring Mumbai at par with world-class cities. However, for the moment, pubs that serve alcohol will have to wrap up by 1:30, as is the norm right now. Now, the question is the move practical? Will it make business sense? Will it be a security nightmare? Should cities like Delhi follow suit as well? We'll be taking a look at all those issues, all those questions on Epicenter tonight. Before that, here is what Aditya Thackeray has said today.
As Purna Mantri Mandala mi ek avgat kele ki aple hi ji Mumbai 24 tasi ji yojana hai. Sadharanpane 2017 cha je aple cabinet note hoti manzuri hoti ani Shopping Establishment Act jithe amend zalela. त्याच्यानंतर ते जी आर प्रमाणे खरं तर त्याच वेळी मुंबई 24 तास सुरू व्हायला पाहिजे होतं, पण काही कारणास्तव ते झालं नाही. त्यावेळी मला वाटतं क्रेडिट वॉर असेल किंवा काय, पण त्या मागच्या सरकारने ते केलं नाही.
Now surprisingly, the BJP is playing party pooper. They are calling this kill bill, saying that it will only increase incidents like Nirbhaya. I said surprising because it was the Modi government way back in 2016 that had paved the way for India to become a 24/7 country. This is when the cabinet had cleared the model shops and establishment bill that permitted shops, malls, cinema halls and even banks, mind you, to work through the night.
ये नाइट लाइफ का निर्णय तो लेते समय इसकी पार्श्वभूमि ये कहती है कि नाइट लाइफ नहीं किलिंग लाइफ होगा, ये दुर्भाग्य है.
Now, Mumbai is home to 20 million people and it attracts millions of visitors each year. It is a city that operates nearly non-stop. It is also a city that till 1992 had no nanny state telling them to shut shop at any time of the day or night. But things changed dramatically after the communal carnage of 1993. A curfew was put for shops to shut by 10 p.m. and restaurants by 1:30 p.m. Today, the reaction has largely been positive in the city.
What do the people of Mumbai think about the decision that has been taken by the state government of Maharashtra regarding 24/7 concept in the city of Mumbai? I'm joined by a few people here in Worli and I would like to ask them what do they think about this decision, starting from Mr. Shetty, who also owns a hotel here in Mumbai. What he has to say, aapka khud ka hotel hai, kis tarike se dekhte hai, will this benefit you?
Yeah, benefit is the sabse benefit aur isme rozgar milega. और जो भी ये भी स्टेशन कॉलेज में कोई भी बाहर से कोई भी आता है नाइट लाइफ, कोई भी ट्रेन पूरा लेट रहता है, उसके लिए वो लोग भी थोड़ा बहुत तो फूड या कन्विंस हो जाएगा उसको एवरीथिंग.
सिचुएशन ऐसा है कि पॉलिटिकली कुछ लोग अपने नाम से उसको ना फायदा लेने के लिए अलग तरीके से प्रेजेंट करते हैं. देखा जाए तो रियल में आप अगर मुंबई में CST देख लीजिए, दादर देख लीजिए, बॉम्बे सेंट्रल देख लीजिए, ये स्टेशन है जो स्टेशन से आसपास के जो रेस्टोरेंट्स है, मॉल्स है, वहाँ पे लोगों को रात में आप देखोगे तो रात को लेट नाइट गाड़ियाँ आती है, लेट नाइट सवेरे लेट अर्ली मॉर्निंग छुट्टी है. एयरपोर्ट आसपास में आप एयरपोर्ट पे आसपास देखेंगे तो एवरी इंटरनेशनल फ्लाइट का काउंटिंग कर लीजिए कि कितनी है. जो इंटरनेशनल लोग इंडिया में मुंबई में स्पेशली आ रहे हैं तो उनको नाइट में जो सुविधा मिलेगी उस सुविधा की वजह से कुछ लोगों को रोजगार भी मिलेगा. इससे नेशनल इंटरनेशनल लोग जो आ रहे हैं उनके कुछ फॉरेन करेंसी जो फायदा होगा उसके स्टेट गवर्नमेंट को मिलेगा, BMC को मिलेगा, इंडिया को मिलेगा, जाहिर सी बात है, और बेरोजगारों को रोजगार मिलेगा. तो जो हो रहा है मेरे हिसाब से तो बहुत ही अच्छा है.
एक यंगस्टर होने के नाते आप किस तरीके से देखते हैं ये बेनिफिट करेगा? जो यंगस्टर्स है वो जाएंगे रात को यहाँ पे, क्योंकि अनलेस एंड अनटिल इसको रिस्पॉन्स नहीं मिलेगा तो ये सक्सेसफुल भी नहीं होगा, किस तरीके से देखते हैं?
आई थिंक द गवर्नमेंट शुड नीड टू यू नो इंश्योर द सिक्योरिटी एंड द नाइट लाइफ इज ऑलरेडी बीन ऑपरेशनल इन एवरी सिटीज एंड ऑल. So there is nothing which is, you know, there is new in this law. And if the security has been taken care, I think it's a good, you know, step ahead to take care and to increase the business in terms of retail. terms of the pubs and discos business.
So now talking about you, you say there are a lot of eateries in this particular area on this road, and there is also a lot of residents who stay here. So what do you have to say about it being a resident of this area? Will this move be something that you would appreciate?
See, main issue is that residents around these areas have major issue about the parking, which is, you know, people come to the restaurants, just parking is not available, yet they park it on the road. So residents find it very difficult to move in and out of their houses. Second is that most of these restaurants which have these music, loud music, now that there is no control about the loud music, which goes on to very late in the night, till 12, 1 o'clock, till the time the restaurants are open. Now the police is not able to control that. Then if it is 24/7, how will the police be able to control that sound levels which are emitting from these restaurants?
There are concerns that are of course being raised as well, primarily about security, about traffic as well, about the loud music. Are these genuine concerns? How does a city that does not sleep impact its citizens and its economy? Let me straight away introduce my guests this evening. Dilip Datwani, he's the former president of the Hotel and Restaurant Association, Western India. He's joining us from Mumbai this evening. Thank you very much, Dilip Datwani, for joining us. Chandrasekhar Prabhu is an urban planner, again from the city of Mumbai. Tuhin Sinha, spokesperson of the BJP based in Mumbai. Dhanraj Vanjari, he's a former ACP of Mumbai Police, and Vijay Krishna is a leader of the Shiva Sena. He's joining us from Chennai this evening, a city, mind you, that did experiment with having its commercial establishments open through the night, hasn't done very well there. Mr. Datwani, let me speak to you first. You represent the hotel and restaurant industry that perhaps will be one of the biggest beneficiaries of Mumbai remaining open 24/7. Just help us understand how this benefits you and the city that you live in.
First and foremost, it benefits the citizens. People who are going out working late, you know, and when they come back home, freshen up, have a bath and go, it's time for the last order. So those people are going to benefit. Okay, for establishments, we may benefit. That's still to be seen, because we have to keep extra staff, extra electricity, everything will cost. Definitely it's going to be, we have to watch. But we welcome the move. We really appreciate Mr. Aditya Thackeray's initiative in this way, because somebody mentioned that it's more going to be an attractive for foreigners also who come in. They find it, the city is, you know, closed by 1 o'clock. So today when they come down from a flight, they want to have a bite or something, they've got a place to go to. They may have to go to shop, they can shop. It's really appreciated.
Okay,
the lady had some issues about parking, noise of the music.
Mr. Datwani, here's the thing. You know, when Aditya
Thackeray... Can I tell you, because...
Yeah, go ahead. Okay, finish your point, then I'll ask you a counter question. Go ahead.
That lady mentioned about the noise of the music and, you know, parking. This is only for close gate areas in malls, and it's going to be near, you know, Lower Parel and all that, where they are already inside, the parking is inside, security is there, everything is there. So residents are not going to be disturbed at all.
Mr. Datwani,
your traffic problem will also be eased out.
Here's what I want to understand. You know, when Aditya Thackeray made the announcement today, he cited the night economy of London to say that, you know, the night economy of a city like London is £5 billion. Look at the potential Mumbai has. You in turn are saying, well, it's good for the citizen. You're not exactly sure whether it makes business sense. Have I understood you correctly here?
It's something new, we have to see, because you know, it's only going to be in some selected areas, gated communities, malls. So there definitely those outlets are going to benefit.
Okay. Tuhin Sinha, you know,
there are no two way about that.
Okay, Tuhin Sinha, if the citizens are largely happy, I'm saying largely happy because there are some contrarian views that are coming in, but if shopkeepers are happy, if hotel owners are happy, why is the opposition unhappy? After all, this was your idea only, the BJP's idea.
Shreya, to begin with. I'll explain to you. This government, the present government in Maharashtra, is a classic example of a government with lopsided priorities and the resultant antics which it has to resort to in order to deflect attention from core issues. For example, there is no word on where the metro construction stands in the last 2 months. Anyway, to specifically come to the concerns which we have, in the opening of malls and marketplaces 24/7 is number one. It benefits a very minuscule section of society, which anyway has access to five-star hotels, which are open 24/7, or to the street-side chaiwalas, which also operate 24/7. Now, in terms of pure business sense, I can tell you for a fact that in the present market conditions, the increase in consumption is going to be minuscule by this move. But at the same time, the additional costs by way of electricity, by way of manpower, is going to be humongous, rendering most of these businesses non-profitable. Number three, we know that the Mumbai police, or for that matter, police in other places, is also overstretched. I'm not sure whether the police is equipped to handle the possible law and orders challenges which emerge. And finally, we know for a fact that in Mumbai, 2 out of 5 people suffer from insomnia, insomnia because of stress, because of other conditions. Why do we want to encourage a culture where, you know, abnormal working hours are normalized? It's only going to lead to further health issues.
You know,
at the most, as an experiment, you could have started with one mall, with one mall, and with, you know, purely on the basis of weekend. But I can tell you that the challenges or the detriments exceed the benefits over here.
Okay, but you know the fact is, A, this is still a pilot project. It's going to impact, I think, some 20 odd malls and no more. Secondly, very importantly, when you talk about the security challenge, many people would argue and say, and I'll let the Shiva Sena representative here argue with you on that, but the fact is that if you have more people on the streets at night, that only makes your city safer. Many people would argue that. And the second point I'd want to make here,
not necessarily,
the second point I want to make here very quickly is this. This is optional, right? No one is forcing shopkeepers, brand owners, multiplexes to open shop through the night. If they find it profitable, they can do it. If they don't find it profitable, they can just dump the idea. No one is forcing it down, down their throat. The only point I'm trying to make is that maybe this is an idea whose time has come. Vijay Krishna, respond to the concerns that are being raised by Tuhin Sinha here. He's saying this doesn't seem practical at all, that you need a particular ecosystem for the nightlife in a city to thrive, and that ecosystem does not exist in Mumbai right now.
Good evening, Maria Shakil. I would like to say
Maria is on leave.
Called nightlife. Our tourism and environment and protocol minister Aditya Thackeray ji introduced this project as part of tourism. As we know that Mumbai is one of the richest city in our country, and we have got many international cities attracting tourists. So does Sinha believe that tourists come only in the morning? And he sees elitist mind that can Vijay Krishna belong to a middle class family, have lunch or dinner at any point in a five-star hotel? No, it is possible. It is not possible. So say I've landed or just reached Mumbai at around 2 a.m. So Sinha says that I can't have idli sambar either in Saravana or Sangeeta chain of restaurants in Mumbai. So I'm saying that we all need to welcome it.
Okay.
And we are aware. One second, I never disturb you, Sinha. I would like to say, they're saying that we are killing life, but I'm not a politician, but I would like to bring it to the fore. Their own BJP, UP MLA, I just can't recall his name, maybe Kuldeep Shankar, the minor woman came for livelihood and he raped her. He killed her life, he killed the victim, and he was convicted under POSCO. Now he's serving.
Can we have a serious debate, please?
Under what circumstances this rape took place? One second, Sinha, because
Mr.
Ashish, yes, I'm sticking to the
topic. No, Shreya, somebody, I challenge somebody who can't name five commercial places in Mumbai. What right has he got to lecture the people of Mumbai? I challenge you, just name five commercial places in Mumbai.
Sinha ji,
just name five commercial centers in Mumbai.
Mr. Krishna, aap meri baat suniye. All right, Tuhin, just a minute. Mr. Krishna,
just mention five commercial centers in Mumbai and I will take you at face value.
Tuhin, just a minute. Mr. Krishna, Mr. Krishna, here, let me ask you a question here. Let me ask you a question here. The fact is that the government of Tamil Nadu, I'm just moving away from Mumbai to give you an example because you come from the city of Chennai, you're representing the Shiva Sena from there today. The fact is that even the government of Tamil Nadu, you know, tried this experiment. Even in Chennai, establishments, if they want, idli sambar shops, if they want, malls, if they want, multiplexes, if they want, can be open 24/7. But it's an experiment that has failed in Chennai. Absolutely.
Maria Shakil ji, this is...
Arre sir, main Shreya hu. You have to... Sir, 1 minute, aap sunte to hai nahi, ruk jaiye. Arre 1 minute sir, for you first you listen to me. Maria Shakil is on chutti. No problem. Maria is on chutti, so I'm filling in for her.
Mujhe baat karne ka mauka dijiye. बात करने का मौका दीजिए. हर शहर को एक कलाचार होते हैं, एक कल्चर होते हैं. मुंबई का मुंबई डेफिनेटली इज एन इंटरनेशनल सिटी. सो यू शुड नॉट एक्सपेक्ट दैट दिस काइंड ऑफ एक्सपेरिमेंट विल बी मेड इन पुणे और एनी अदर सिटी इन महाराष्ट्र. बट आई एम सेइंग दैट दिस विल सक्सीड एंड दिस वी आर डूइंग इन नॉन रेजिडेंशियल एरियाज. Like our co-panelist has said, and I think if I'm correct me if I'm wrong, in the areas like Kalagoda, GKC, Nariman Point, and gated commercial entities. So we'll be evaluating, we'll see its impact. And we met with all the hoteliers. And I'm proud to say that my grandfather was a Udupi hotelier.
Okay. Chandrasekhar Prabhu, you're a town planner. Now, Mumbai is India's richest city. I think one of our panels has also mentioned that already. It accounts for 6% of India's GDP. The question is this: if more people step out day or night, spend money, how's that a bad thing? I mean, do you buy this entire, it may not be safe, it may not make business sense argument? Because the fact is that cities, global cities across the world remain open through the night and they seem to be thriving.
I think this entire discussion is going haywire. Let us understand the ground realities in Mumbai. There are 21 branches of banks in Mumbai which are open 24 hours. I go to my branch at 2 o'clock in the morning and it's open, and it's been open for 7 or 8 years, 10 years to be precise. So that has been happening. All ATMs, as you know, are open 24 hours. Ladies go at 2 o'clock, 3 o'clock, 4 o'clock and go to the ATM, withdraw the money. There is no law and order problem there. Number three, even today, the Pav Bhaji stalls and other stalls in Mumbai are open till wee hours in the morning. Some of them continue through the night. Now, in a place like Girgaon Chowpatty, where you get the Bhelpuri and you get Kulfi, where there are at least 50 policemen policing the Chowpatty, if the Bhelpuri wala wants to continue till wee hours in the morning, why should anyone stop him? I just don't understand. If he finds it economically viable, he will continue with it.
Correct.
We have in Mumbai 7,800 medical shops which are open 24/7, and people go and buy medicines at wee hours in the morning. We have other shops which in the last 2 years have been kept open for 24/7. So this is going on. There are even restaurants. Let me come to restaurants. Though the present decision doesn't cover the restaurants at all, and they are supposed to shut down at 1:30. I can give you innumerable examples. Being a teetotaler, when friends invite for parties, I have to go, and the guy who's not drunk has to remain there till the end because he needs to help people to get into cabs and things like that.
Okay.
I have seen restaurants being open till 3:30, 4:30 in the morning, even today, though the official time is 1:30.
Okay.
And they manage it. How do they manage it? They manage it, they give bribes or whatever. So Mumbai life is like this, and 24/7, the whole city works. And
correct. I get your point.
It's not because of X, Y, or Z that this nightlife is happening.
I get
your
point.
This is an international city, and there is nobody who can stop it. The market forces are at work. If it is not practical, it won't succeed. If it is practical, then the person will keep his restaurant open.
Therefore,
people will come. Therefore, if it is the practical, BJP's opposition, then the malls will be flooded.
Therefore,
with people.
Is the BJP's opposition
practical? The malls won't start.
Therefore, is the BJP's opposition simply for the sake of opposing Dhanraj Banjari? Just very quickly, you know, before I get some voices from Delhi, bring in the police point of view. There is a security concern that the BJP is raising. Is that a valid one? Because, you know, as Mr. Prabhu has just pointed out, Mumbai in any case is a city that's constantly on the move. It already is a 24/7 city. Will a move like this stress out the police? Like
Shreya, let me tell you, I worked in Mumbai police for long 35 years. Those who are talking about the over-tracing the police, they perhaps do not understand two things. Number one, that trace and police are like nuptial joints. They are together. And number two, they do not know the capacity, integrity and competence of Mumbai police. Let me tell you, our police stations are working 24/7. In a night shift, we have once two, three station house officers manned with minimum 10, plus we have 10 members of detection staff, we have 10 members of surveillance staff, plus we have three vehicles moving patrolling in one police station and one SRP platoon reserved at the zonal level. Now let me come to this decision, that when state government has taken the decision, state governments has taken the decision in the cabinet council of ministers of Maharashtra. Number two, when this decision was taken, the commissioner of police and director general of police were well taken in confidence.
Correct.
You must understand one thing, Mumbai differs with four dimensions: socio economic cultural and geographical. Those who understand these four different dimensions of Mumbai as a speciality of this island, let there no compromise and no compare with any other city in the
Tuhin
state
Sina?
And I welcome this decision. For political sake they are arguing. It's a futile argument, it's a lame
Tuhin
excuses.
Sina, I'll give you 20 seconds. You have heard everyone out. Everyone on this panel except you agrees with what Aditya Thackeray has done. They are saying Mumbai in any case is a 24/7 city. Ab ek naya law aa gaya, usse aapko kya dikkat hai? If the police is working 24/7, if restaurants are willing to work 24/7, if malls are ready to work 24/7, BJP ko kya problem hai? It was your idea in the first place.
See, like everybody else has said, Mumbai, we all acknowledge Mumbai to be a 24/7 city. There has been enormous existing activity 24/7, which only makes this announcement a gimmick. When are we going to hear, when are the metro rails being,
you're changing your argument.
13 metro rails are being constructed at breakneck speed. What's
now
happening
you're calling
then?
This a gimmick.
And in the next few months, you will see that the benefits of the present decision of opening these malls 24/7 is minimal.
Let's wait and watch. You know, we'll just have to wait and watch what the impact of the decision, I beg your pardon, is going to be. But almost every Mumbaikar has welcomed it. Should such a move be replicated in Delhi? Surprisingly, Delhiites are saying no. Take a look.
Delhi elections are underway, and amidst that, there is a piece of news item which then also came in from Mumbai. And that news item was that nightlife is now going to get some platform in the city of Mumbai. Mumbai city, which is known as a city which never sleeps, is also going to get shopping malls, theatres and other markets which are going to remain open 24/7 in Mumbai. Can such a model be also replicated in the national capital in Delhi?
Aaj Mumbai mein night life approve ho gayi hai ki pura raat bhar dukane khula karegi, shopping mall khula karege. Delhi elections aa rahe hai abhi, lagta hai ye Delhi mein bhi possible hai, aur agar possible hai to kya kya cheeze pehle honi chahiye wahan pe?
Abhi to lagta nahi ki Delhi mein possible hai, jis hisab se agar Mumbai kar raha hai, kyunki Mumbai mein main 2 saal reh ke aaya hu, to Mumbai kafi safe hai Delhi ke muqable. Agar karu to kafi safe hai. Agar raat ko aap 2 baje bhi utar rahe hain तो आपको कोई किसी तरीके की दिक्कत नहीं है, पुलिस अच्छी तरह से, सिक्योरिटी है यहाँ पे, वो नहीं दिखाई देता.
ये पूछना चाह रहा हूँ आपसे कि मुंबई में आज क्या नया रूल आया है कि पूरे 24 घंटा वहाँ दुकानें खुल पाएगी, थिएटर खुल पाएगा, शॉपिंग मॉल खुल पाएगा, मार्केट खुल पाएगा? क्या दिल्ली में भी वो होना चाहिए ए, और अगर दिल्ली में होना चाहिए तो क्या दिल्ली रेडी है उस टाइप के इंफ्रास्ट्रक्चर के लिए?
नो, इसके लिए दिल्ली तो बिल्कुल रेडी नहीं है, क्योंकि अगर यहाँ पे 18 आवर भी मार्केट मतलब ओपन होता है, देन नाइट में ऐसे ऐसे कांड हो रहे, निर्भया कांड, बहुत सारे ऐसे रेप, मतलब दिल्ली में तो होना ही नहीं चाहिए, कुछ सेफ ही नहीं है। जब दिन में सेफ नहीं है और थोड़ा 10 o'clock या 12 o'clock तक सेफ नहीं है, तो 24 hours फिर नाइट में फिर कैसे सेफ करेगी? गवर्नमेंट इसको मेंटेन ही नहीं कर पाएगी।
व्हाट हैज पीपल हैज बीन सेइंग अबाउट मुंबई इज दैट मुंबई इज ओपन 24/7, इवन बिफोर द कॉन्सेप्ट ऑफ 24/7 वॉज इम्प्लाइड इन मुंबई, पीपल वर सो सेफ इनफ दैट दे वर यू नो टेलिंग पीपल दैट मुंबई इज ओपन 24/7, यू कैन वॉक अराउंड मुंबई एनी टाइम एट एनी टाइम। सो दैट काइंड ऑफ मेंटेलिटी एंड थॉट्स शुड बी इन द दिल्ली पीपल फर्स्ट, देन ओनली यू कैन एक्चुअली हैव दिस कॉन्सेप्ट ऑन पेपर इटसेल्फ दैट यू नो द शॉप्स एंड मॉल शुड बी ओपन फॉर 24/7।
Mr. Prabhu, I'm coming to you. I have exactly 30 seconds. Are you surprised with the reaction that is coming from Delhi? They are saying Mumbai mein to theek hai, Mumbai is a safe city, but not Delhi. Delhi is way too unsafe for us to have the city functioning 24/7.
No, Delhi, unfortunately, I have lived in Delhi for quite some time. I have been with my family. The culture in Delhi is very different from Mumbai. If you ask a girl who uses public transportation, out of 100 girls, if you ask them how many of them have got pinched in a public transportation, you will find a very high percentage of people who would say that yes, they have seen pinching, bottom pinching and other things in the buses. I have seen in Delhi this happen.
Okay.
So Delhi, unless the culture changes, the kind of people coming to Delhi, the level at which they operate and the way in which they look at the female sex is something which doesn't make me comfortable, at least.
Okay.
As a matter of principle, however, any city working 24/7 should be the ultimate goal, but then there has to be some caveats to that, and those caveats will have to be followed by Delhi. Even Delhi sooner or later will follow suit.
Okay.
But there has to be lot of patrolling, there has to be lot of thought process that has to go into this.
All right, thank you very much.
But finally, all metros will have to take this decision.
All right. Thank you very much, Mr. Prabhu, for joining us. Dilip Datwani, Chandrasekhar Prabhu, Tuhin Sinha, Dhanraj Banjari and Vijay Krishna. Thank you very much for joining us here on Epicenter. With that, it's a wrap from me. News and updates continue. Do keep watching.